Wagner returned with a second man, not part of the delegation. He was in his mid-30s, short, with close-cropped hair and wide shoulders. Although in civilian clothes, Yumatov guessed from his manner that he was in the military. He began to get to his feet, but Wagner waved him to stay where he was.
"This is Naval Captain Alexander Vitruk," he said. "He has flown in from Vladivostok to see us."
Vitruk went on to become commander of the Eastern Division and led the ill-fated Diomede operation. He had pulled out a chair and sat down. He did not ask who Yumatov was and said only,
"You have the inventory?"
"From the warehouse? Yes, sir."
"How much?"
"A total of 2,200 kilograms of nuclear material, sir, including 670 kilograms of U-235.
"How is it packed?"
"Beryllium alloy casing, sealed in reinforced stainless steel canisters, ready for transportation."
Vitruk stared out of the window into the gloom of the winter night.
70?
He asked Wagner.
4, maybe 5,
the German scientist answered. At that moment, Yumatov had no idea what they were talking about. Vitruk, his gaze still outside, nodded to Wagner, who said,
"My specialty is a small and powerful nuclear weapon delivered with the lightest possible metal. We are experimenting with a magnesium-based alloy, light like aluminum, strong like titanium."
At exactly that point, Yumatov knew what he had to do, while also realizing this was what he wanted to do. Had he refused, he suspected he would have ended up dead that night, his body thrown into the icy depths of the Ulba River. Wagner and Vitruk planned to siphon off 70 kilograms of U-235, which would make 4 or 5 nuclear weapons and give them and whatever organization they were forming an independent nuclear deterrent.